Time is money, especially when you're building an online store. The faster that you can get your Shopify store up and running, the sooner you can actually start making sales. So let's start this process. AI powered design tools like Gem Pages or Shogun can actually help you generate these layouts, fonts, color schemes, everything in minutes. And it's actually pretty cool. So instead of starting from scratch, what we're gonna use is, for this example, we're gonna use Gem Pages and just kind of show you how quickly we could potentially copy maybe an existing website, right? That we know, hey, I love this layout. I like how these things are displayed here. And we want to try to copy as much as we can, put it into AI and build that homepage right there. So Gem Pages, we have it installed in here. Let's go ahead and go to Pages, create new page. And then something else that would actually like save you a lot of time is Gem Pages already has a bunch of pre-built templates, right? So as you can see here, like there's this sock money or sock subscription template that it may potentially just work really well with your brand. The drawback to, for example, starting from a theme, I think themes are great because they give you a lot of flexibility depending on the theme that you get. But when you install the theme for the very first time, nothing is built out for you, right? You're basically starting from scratch and you're trying to figure out, do I use this section? Do I not? Like, so it just gives you all the tools. It says, hey, these are all the tools available. Now start building. Versus starting with something like Gem Pages, there are pre-built templates already in here, which is very much a plug and play for a lot of these sections. So you may not use, you know, everything, but it's gonna give you just a really good example of that particular page. So if we see homepage in here, is there any clothing? Yeah, you see you have bikini and swimwear here, already pre-built for you. This one also looks like it's clothing. So there's quite a few clothing in here. This is fashion for mommy. So like a mommy and me type thing. And they're great. I mean, this is a great way to just kickstart things off very quickly. Now, we're actually gonna try to use the AI tool, right? That's provided within Gem Pages. Now, this AI tool is still in beta, so they're still working through some kinks. But one of the coolest things is like you literally upload either an image. So if you have already some mockups that you have sort of drawn out, you can upload those images in here, or you can basically copy and paste a URL. So if you have a website that you admire and you want to maybe copy some of the sections and the way that they have it structured, you can very easily copy and paste that in there. So that's what we're going to try today. So we're going to click on image to layout is the feature. And again, this is still on beta, and this will tell you, give you some guidelines here on the side where they want you to have a simple, clean, you know, layout, versus this other one down here has like multiple images sort of like stacked on top of each other. The background, it just looks very busy. So they're trying to tell you like, avoid busyness, give us something, you know, clean that the AI can actually capture from. So a clothing store that I found was Gap, and it looks very clean. And I think that it should do a pretty good job with this particular page. So we're gonna test it out. Grab gap.com. We're gonna go back over here. We're gonna paste our link and let's click on generate. Oh, all right. So it automatically starts to recognize the sections that I have in here. And as you can see over here on the right-hand side, we can pick and choose which sections we actually want to fully replicate. It looks like there was maybe a couple that it recognized that are not really anything. So like this right here is just like a blank space in between the hero and the new arrivals. So it looks like we have the hero, the new arrivals, we have more products, it recognized that, even the footer. Okay, let's see how this works. Now, this right here, everything that we're doing with the image to layout functionality, we'll see how good this is. But this is on the paid plan. The paid plan gives you the ability to do 300 sections for a single month, essentially. So let's see, 291 this month. Okay, perfect. Let's try to hit generate and see what happens. All right, so it's done. That was maybe a minute, maybe less. But as you can see, like, again, it's not perfect, but it gives you the breakdown. And again, if you're trying to replicate something that's already been built already, this will basically tried its best to do a good job. And it really does a good job. So if you know a little bit about HTML, you'll see that, for example, this section right here, this is just a category breakdown, right, of some of your main products. You can see like it has a row, then it has individual images for each of these. So it's individual columns. It recognizes that this is a hero banner. So it automatically categorizes all the sections as what it thinks it is. Then we have an image here. We have text. We have more text basically over here. I think this one actually got the actual button. Yeah, it did. And some text. It's kind of finicky with the actual image. Obviously the images will change and will switch out because you have that cache soft. Let me see where that came from. Okay, yeah, this is kind of part of the graphic overall versus, yeah, yeah, this is the text and then the button right here. It was able to capture that. Now, I don't think it captured the fact that this was like a split image, which is fine, but I mean, you have a big banner image essentially just right within here. So as you can see, in a minute, we can have essentially a homepage almost completely designed for you. Some of the things that you'll have to incorporate in here, it's gonna be your logos, your colors, your actual imagery. And that's the beauty about doing something like gem pages is that you have the full flexibility of if you were designing this on a completely different platform, essentially, and not relying on the themes. The themes are good, but they're gonna be very limiting in what you can actually do. So, and let me just kind of give you an example, right? So for example, for this hero banner, for a banner from the theme, you may not have full flexibility on where to, how to arrange the content, right? This gives you different layout options, how to arrange the content, the source of it being either a color, an image, or a video, right? All built out within just this right here. And then beyond that, it actually gives you granular control in terms of percentages or pixels for all these things. So if your goal is to get started quicker, faster, then using something like Gem Pages Builder to get there a little bit faster by using the AI tool to automatically generate your pages, then you're going to cut your time probably in half. Now, there is a little bit of a learning curve, right? With learning gem pages and how this works. So that's also, you're gonna increase your time spent a little bit like somewhere else, right? But as far as the actual layout, gem pages or something similar, I believe Shogun also have something similar to this. I don't know if Pagefly is the other page builder that Shopify has as an app. They might have something very similar to this. Now, hey, in the past year, we've actually helped over 250 clothing brands boost their success by adding more than 10 million in extra revenue. And we achieved this through top-notch website optimization, smart ad strategies, and powerful email marketing. If you're new here, I'm Christian Pignon. My business partner is Aaron Pearson, and we release two new videos every single week. Aaron goes deep into the marketing strategies while I focus on mastering Shopify and perfecting your brand's design. Now, the next area that you can use AI is for your product descriptions and your SEO optimization, right? So writing product descriptions and optimizing them for SEO can be very time consuming, especially if you have large inventories. Now, AI tools like Jasper or even Shopify's built-in AI tools can generate compelling product descriptions in just seconds and can save you hours of manual writing. Now, you will be able to actually create more unique, keyword-rich content that actually speaks to your target audience, but also optimize it for search engines, which is gonna be very important. So this is gonna ensure that your products rank higher in search results while also driving organic traffic to your Shopify store. And to me, I think the most important part about creating text-generated AI content is that you're still inserting your own touch to it, right? And making sure that, sure, you have the base or the foundation for it, but tweaking that to add personal touches or highlighting specific product features, this will actually maintain a little bit more authenticity while speeding up this process. And if you haven't done this yet, if you go to your product and you click on one of your products in the back end, you'll see that we have this description in here, but we have the ability to enhance it with AI. So we can actually rephrase, we can extend, or we can even simplify. So if we want to extend it, we can click on that. And then we can switch the tone of it. We can do playful, daring, expert, sophisticated, persuasive, supported. Let's do expert. And then let's click on generate again. And there we go. Now we have expanded basically this product description with just the click of a button. Now, the only, I think, bad part about this is that, yeah, if you have hundreds and hundreds of products, then this process is going to be a little bit slow because you'll have to go on each of your products, generate a text, and then kind of move forward. Now, my suggestion with this would probably be to go through like a ChatGPT or Claude and then just have all of your product information and maybe some kind of spreadsheet that you can upload that spreadsheet into the platform and ask it to do it individually, and it will spit it out. It may take a little bit of time to, you know, organize all this, but that's probably one of the easiest ways that I've done it, where you can add a scale, basically have all these products with the descriptions and maybe any additional details about the product, and then give it all the instructions and all the prompts. If you're interested in some of the prompts that we've used in the past to build Shopify stores, then let us know down below in the comments. Just type in the word prompts and we'll send you some of the prompts that we've used to generate either product descriptions or generate some additional information. Now, the next place that I would use AI to speed up my process is going to be in the visual design and branding. This is where I think there's still a lot of room for growth for AI tools to get better. Obviously, text is gonna be probably the best place that you can actually use AI to accelerate the process. But when it comes to the visual design, branding, creating logos, it's okay. I think that, again, it will give you a good foundation, but you will still probably need to tweak some things. And this is a recording of this video. I don't know, maybe next week they'll come up with something that is absolutely amazing and it blows everything out of the water. Not to say that there isn't anything like that, but it's just not quite there yet. So AI for your design, for design purposes, for example, creating a hero banner, maybe you're just starting from scratch and you need a logo, right? Even creating a simple logo with AI can be a little bit tricky. Things are getting better, I would say, even week by week, not even month by month. But right now, there's nothing really outstanding, right, that will make you a logo and it looks absolutely incredible. There are almost every single platform now, even even Facebook and Instagram now give you the ability for you to create images, right? But I would say definitely Midjourney, it's going to be the best place for you to start that process of creating your logo. There are tools like, I mean, Canva and Luca, which they have AI functionality built in within it, but it's not to the point where I think something like Midjourney can actually help you create. And just to kind of give you an example of like something like Canva, because I know a lot of you have Canva, and Canva has some AI tools and some AI functionality built in within it. As you can see, I just clicked on the search bar here for Canva templates, and I clicked on, basically put the prompt right within there. So create a Facebook cover image of vibrant graffiti art. This right here is called Magic Design. And again, still in beta, so they're working through all this. But all these right here at the very top have been generated by AI based on the prompt that I just gave it. So as you can see, it's like, it's okay. It's not the best. It still seems very simple to some extent. So that's what I said, like, it's not quite there yet, but if anything, it's going to give you a good foundation. It's going to give you a good place for you to start and to get ideas. I think that's one of the best uses of AI when it comes to creating or designing these, is really to get you the ideas. Maybe you're stuck with something that you don't know exactly how to create. This can help you tremendously with that first step. Now, the next place that you can use AI to build your store faster is personalization. So creating tailored shopping experiences for your customers is going to be super, super important. So this is not going to necessarily change the process, the initial process, right, of building the store and getting it launched, but it's going to give you additional tools to help your customers convert a little bit better and easier on your store. So leveraging AI powered personalization tools like Accurate or Jufi is going to create these sort of tailored experiences, right, for every visitor based on how they behave on the website, based on the type of questions that they have, right, if they're using something like Jufi. With Jufi, you're essentially just adding AI to help you with your customer service problems or questions, right, that you may get. So it's, you're adding AI in a way for your customers to communicate with you a little bit easier. And for something like Accurate, it's going to be that personalization, right? So once someone actually comes to the store, depending on where they're coming from, it's going to use AI to change the products that are being recommended. There's a few apps that are using this right now, and some of the best ones are going to be some of the ones that are really for Shopify Plus. But starting with maybe something like this is going to be good, because you can actually automatically recommend products, offer targeted discounts, potentially adjust the layout of your Shopify store to match each of your customers' unique needs in real time. So the personalization is not only going to provide user satisfaction, but the idea is that it's going to provide higher conversions and average order values, because you're trying to make some changes or some tweaks live depending on where the customer is coming from, or if it's the first time or the second time or the third time that they've been to your store. So these things are going to help you out sort of like after you technically launch the site, but are still super, super relevant to what we're talking about. And the ability for you to, it may not be, I guess, to build your store in record time, but to get sales in record time, if you will. Now, lastly, the AI tools that I want you to install or have is some form of AI driven analytics, right? Once your store is actually live, tracking performance and optimizing the user experience can be a little bit tricky and can be time consuming without the right tools. So for me, like, one of my favorite tools out there in order to get analytics is Microsoft Clarity. Microsoft Clarity is free. It's 100% free, and it gives you heat map data. It also gives you session recordings, so you can see exactly how your customers are navigating and behaving through your store. You can identify pain points, rage clicks, excessive scrolling. There's a lot of different things that Microsoft Clarity will give you that Shopify's own data won't be able to give you. So now, where does AI really fit within Microsoft Clarity? Great question. If you go to your session recordings, these are literally like, these are gonna be videos that you'll play and you'll see your customer navigating your website. So maybe we can show you an example here. This is our website. You can see someone went to our homepage. Looks like they went to the about. They were scrolling, looking at the team, looking good. Okay, learning a little bit more about us. Saw the pop-up, they closed it out. So at a glance, you'll be able to see this, right? Now, it's gonna be very time consuming for you to go through each of these videos and figure out what is it that's wrong with them or what's an opportunity, right, for some of these videos. Now, what you can do is you may have like have the last 3 days of data here, and then I have all my videos listed. You can click on the summarize recording, and this is going to use AI to essentially summarize the content of each of these videos and give me some takeaways, some successful things, some things that people were not able to successfully do. And it's gonna give you essentially session insights along with like where that actually happened within the video. So super, super powerful, right? To use AI in a way that you're analyzing the videos and the recordings of the customers coming through on your store. If you don't do anything else with this video except for install Microsoft Clarity and use Microsoft's Copilot, which is their AI, to get these session insights, this right here is going to help you tremendously with your conversion and creating and using AI in your store. So designing Shopify stores with AI doesn't have to take weeks or months. Like, some of these tools that we talked about today should slash the time that it takes you to create a Shopify store, from automating the design tasks to generating product descriptions, etc. Now, there are more tools out there that will help you, again, after you're done building, right? What are the AI tools that I think everyone should have installed within their stores? That's gonna be in this video right here. Check it out.